Hello, welcome to new part of this link tutorial. And in this part, we are going to learn about two important methods of sorting. The methods are then by descending and then by. So if you have seen my last two videos of this tutorial, you will see that we have covered two methods. First one was order by and the second one was order by descending. Now, if the scenario is, suppose I have a list and in that list, we have some names. We have some first name and we have some last name. So using order by or order by descending, if we sort that particular list based on any of the property, suppose I'm sorting the list based on the first name. If the first name are equals in multiple objects, then we need to apply our sorting on the second level also. That's what we are going to learn in our video. So suppose first we need to sort our data based on the first name, and if the first name matches, then we will sort our data based on some other property. That property may be in descending order or in the ascending order. So that's what we are going to learn in this video. In this video, we will cover then by method and then by descending method. Then we will create multiple examples of both the methods in both the syntax, the query syntax and the method syntax. So let's start. And first, let's see what are then by and then by descending methods. So then by method is used to sort data on the second level and so on in ascending order. Suppose I have applied my sorting using order by or order by descending, and then on the second level I need to sort my data based on some other property, or at the third level, if the second level also matches, then at the third level I need to sort my data based on any third property in the ascending order. Then for that case we use then by method. Then by descending is also same like then by, but the difference is that then by descending will sort the data in the descending order. These methods are used with order by or order by descending method. So these methods cannot be used independently. There should be order by or order by descending before these methods. You can apply then by with both the methods, that is order by or order by descending, or you can use then by descending with both the methods. So suppose first you have written order by and then you can sort the data using then by descending, or first you have order by descending and then you can sort the data using the then by. So you can create your combinations based on the requirement and you can write your link query to get the desired output. So the example of this type is first sort on the first name and then sort on the second name. So suppose I have a contacts list, and in that contact list I have some names, first name and the last name, and if I need to sort the data, suppose the first name, there is a match in the first name, suppose for two contacts the first name is equal, then I want to sort my data on the last name. Now let's see how can we do that using the examples. So to create the examples, let's go back to the Visual Studio. Here I am in my Visual Studio and this is a console application. In this console application, I have a program class and I have a employee class. Employee class has four properties: ID, first name, last name and email. And in the program class, I have created a data source using these properties for the employee. And basically it is a list of employee. You can see the data source. It is a list of employee and it has some records, four records, and it has ID, email, last name and the first name. Then same ID is 2, email, this is the email, last name, first name is Mark, and for the third record ID is 1, email is alan@email.com, then the last name and first name is Mark. So you will notice that the first name of two record is same. So for the second and third object the first name is same, and for the first and last record first name is also same. So now let's see in this scenario what happens if my first name is equal to another object and then I need to sort my data based on some other property. Let's see how can we do that. First, let's create our query using the method syntax. So we will write MS, that is method syntax. So our data source, so data source is data source. Then order by, you can use order by or order by descending based on your requirement. So suppose now I'm using order by and I need my order by based on the first name. So suppose I'm writing the emp such that emp dot first name. The thing is that I need my list to be sorted based on the first name, and then simply I write toList here. And if I need to show the data on the console screen, then I have to write all the things in the for each loop, and this is the ID, and this is suppose the first name. This is the example from the previous video, so I'm gonna change it a little bit as per the new requirement. So first name, and then I will write the last name. So first, without doing anything, let me press F5 and let's see what is the output. So here you will see that we have our four records, and the records are sorted using the first name. You can see first we have foo, then mark and mark. Now if you talk about first two records, suppose in these two records first name matches, first there is a match of the first name, and then if there is a match, then I need my list to be sorted based on the last name. Suppose now in the current scenario the last name is sorted based on the descending order, and I need my last name also to be sorted in ascending order. So what I want my list to be sorted first using the first name in the ascending order, and if there is a match in the first name, then I need my list to be sorted based on the last name in the ascending order. Now let's see how can we do that. So notice the output. Now we have the last name is Smith and the last name is Anderson for the first two records. The thing is that we are going to apply a second level sorting in ArcGUI, and to apply that second level sorting we have a method thenby. Thenby method is used to sort the data in the ascending order. Now suppose I need to further create a sorting, emp dot, on what property I am going to apply my sorting? Last name. So first I have used order by, and now I am using thenby. So order by will sort data in the ascending order on the first name, and then if there is a match, thenby will sort the data in the ascending order on the last name. Now let's press F5 and let's see what is the output. So you will see that if there is a match in the first name, then the data is sorted using the last name. You can see that the last name is Anderson and the Smith. So, and if you need your data to be sorted on the some other properties, then you can use that property. And again, if there is a match in the last name also and you need to go to third level, then you can write one more thenby method after this thenby dot thenby, then and then so on. You can create n numbers of sorting based on your requirement. So basically this was my requirement, and now let's see how can we do the same thing in the query syntax. For that let me write a query syntax. Now let's write the simple structure, the basic structure of the query, which is from, and it is emp in data source, and then first we need to sort the data. Suppose I'm sorting the data in the descending order. So suppose order by emp dot, and it is the first name, and I'm sorting this data in the descending order, and you will see that we don't have any thenby or thenby descending method in this query syntax. So how can we do that? To sort data on the second or third level, you need to write a comma. This is the comma, and then you can write your second property. So suppose my first property was first name, and now I need my data to be sorted on emp dot last name. And if you need your data in the ascending order, then you don't have to do anything, or simply you can write ascending, but this is not mandatory. By default it is ascending. If you need your second level to be sorted in the descending order, then you can use descending also here. So suppose I need to sort my data in the descending order, and if there is a match, then I need my last name to be sorted in the descending order. And now let me select emp, and to execute this query at this place I'm going to use toList method, although it is not required because we are using for each loop display the data. So let me remove that. Let's change the data source in the for each loop. I will write here qs because of the query syntax, and let me press F5 again. So here you will see that then the list is sorted based on the first name in the descending order, because first we have mark and then we have foo. And if there is a match in the first name, suppose the mark is equal in both the first two objects, then the sorting is done using the last name, and also it is sorted in the descending order because that's what we have written in our query. You can see that employee dot last name descending. So that's why the second level sorting is done in the descending order. For next two records also, first name is equal and the second level of sorting is done in the descending order on the last name. If you need to sort this second level in the ascending order, then you simply have to remove this descending, or you can write ascending here, or by default it is ascending, so you don't have to specify it here, and you can simply press F5. And now you will see that the first name, if the first name is equal, then the last name is sorted in the ascending order. So that's how you can use your then by and then by descending method in your query. If you need to go further at the third level in query syntax, then again press a comma and then you can write your third property. So suppose I'm writing employee.id. In our case, because there is no match in the last name, so there is no need to write the third one. But if in your case you have a match in the second property also, then you can create your own hierarchy and you can go to n numbers of order in your query. So that's how we sort our data using the order by descending, then by and then by descending methods. That's all in this video. If you like my videos, please subscribe the channel and hit the like button of the video. Thank you.